This video demonstrates a plastic weld repair on a cracked Yamaha R6 front upper fairing. The crack measures approximately 2 inches in length and extends completely through the plastic. Begin by cleaning the damaged area on both the front and back sides of the fairing using a dedicated plastic cleaner. This removes contaminants that could compromise weld integrity. Apply aluminum tape over the crack on the front side of the fairing. This serves as a backing surface when welding on the back side. On the back side of the fairing, grind a groove along the crack, ensuring the crack remains centered within the groove. At the end of the crack, where it reaches the edge of the part, grind a perpendicular groove. This will accommodate a cross-stitch weld to enhance the strength of the repair. Remove all plastic shavings using a dry cloth or compressed air. Do not re-clean the area with plastic cleaner. Proceed with the weld. The fairing is made from ABS plastic. Therefore, an ABS welding rod must be used. Weld a single pass of round welding rod into the main groove to fill the crack. Ensure that both the rod and the base material melt simultaneously at the point of contact to achieve proper fusion. Then weld a pass along the perpendicular groove to complete the cross-stitch reinforcement. If needed, apply a second pass to fully fill the groove. Reheat the welds with the hot air welder, then use the airless welder to smooth the surface. Allow the weld to cool completely to room temperature. Remove the aluminum tape from the front side of the fairing and apply it over the weld on the back side. Clean the front side with plastic cleaner to remove any adhesive residue. Grind a deep groove along the crack on the front side, keeping the crack centered. A cross-stitch weld is not required on the front side, so a groove is not needed along the edge. Remove all plastic shavings using a dry cloth or compressed air. Do not re-clean the area with plastic cleaner. Weld two passes of round ABS rod into the groove to fill the crack. Again, ensure that both the rod and the base material melt simultaneously at the point of contact to achieve proper fusion. Use the airless welder to smooth the weld surface while keeping the plastic pliable with the hot air welder. Allow the weld to cool completely to room temperature. Once the weld is cooled, remove the tape from the back side of the fairing. Grind the weld on the front side flush with the surrounding surface. Sand the weld using 80 grit sandpaper, and then use 180 grit to sand the entire front side of the fairing to prepare for refinishing. Remove all sanding dust. Because the fairing is made from a rigid plastic, a hard set filler epoxy is required. Mix and apply the epoxy over the repair. Once cured, sand and block the epoxy using 80 grit sandpaper, finishing with 180 grit to restore the original contour. Remove all sanding dust and wipe the part clean with a tack cloth. Apply primer to the entire front side of the fairing. After the primer is dried, block sand the surface with 320 grit sandpaper. Repeat the priming and sanding process as needed to achieve a uniform finish. Once the final primer coat is dry, scuff the front side of the fairing with 800 grit sandpaper or a scuff pad to prepare it for paint. The fairing is fully restored and ready for installation. It looks and fits as if it just left the factory.